Come on, chip
All
shot,
right,
mate.
I am.
Take three couples who love to entertain. Ask each pair to throw a dinner party.
I am phobic of eggs.
Right, we're going to have to get a chip shot before we go.
And get them to score each other in secret.
15.
Today, caring couples.
I got a hold of Sean's mole and bit Sean's mole off.
And squabbling spouses.
There are serious cracks appealing in your relationship.
What you've just said tonight is, I find, quite offensive.
Yeah.
As each pair competes to win a £1,000 prize.
It was nice, but it was a boiled egg.
It wasn't just a boiled egg, Sean. That was quite complex.
Today on Couples Come Dine With Me, we're in Birmingham, a city that tops the list for failed marriages, with 2,800 applications for divorce last year alone. Not that our first hosts have any plans to add to that statistic. 42-year-old Amanda and her 45-year-old hubby Anthony, who've been together 18 years.
Come on.
Whoopsie.
We met in a bar, and as corny as it sounds, our eyes met across the room, and it was literally love at first sight.
Lust.
Charming.
And that was it. We've been together ever since.
18 years.
Yeah. Long years.
But at least Amanda could spend that time getting used to her husband.
Slow down.
It takes a long time for someone to go, do you know what, he's not a bad bloke. But when people usually meet me, it's not the greatest in the world.
Well, that bodes well. Anthony will be taking charge in the kitchen with Amanda ably assisting.
But you only want it on a low heat,
yes,
so...
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
But you keep using that big one and
yes,
that
well.
Gets... Yeah, but that gets too hot, so if you put it on a smaller one...
I don't want to put it on a smaller one.
Hob chosen, it's time to prep the starter. Dippy duck eggs and soldiers.
My hate,
oh my God,
total
this
hate, is eggs, any type of egg.
Our second couple are 30-year-old Elsie and 32-year-old Ollie, who both run businesses at the festivals.
Jump on it, jump on it.
I take it the business isn't erecting tents.
Elsie moved in fairly quickly after we first met, about 6 weeks after we finished one of the festivals.
It's very exciting. We're definitely not an old married couple yet, I don't think.
Can you give us a minute, guys?
Oh, don't mind us.
We're both quite different. I'm vegetarian. Ollie's now a part-time vegetarian, aren't you, darling?
Yes, darling.
Jolly good, darlings. Back in the kitchen, Anthony starts by boiling duck eggs for 5 minutes. Once cooled, they're ready for peeling.
Don't tap it too hard. Don't tap it too hard.
I didn't. It just popped.
Just be careful.
Give her a chance.
Do you not think I don't understand that?
What are you doing? You put it into the egg, you dozy bird.
Oh dear. Try again.
Do you want me to have a go?
Oh.
Yes. Yes.
Yay! Thank goodness for that. The eggs will be deep fried in breadcrumbs just before serving. Next up, dessert. Burnt English cream surprise with honeycomb and a chocolate brownie.
You don't really like cream, do you?
I'm not a big fan of cream. I like burnt things. And I love honeycomb and chocolate.
Sounds nice.
I like the sound of that.
I don't like the thought of burnt.
It could.
I'd do that without trying, so God knows what they're going to do to make it a dessert.
Completing the lineup are 35-year-old financial advisor Stephen and his 30-year-old civil partner Sean.
You really ought to get a new car.
Why? That's perfectly fine.
I know, but it looks a bit rubbish next to my car. Sean and I are complete opposites.
Complete.
We have nothing in common whatsoever.
I don't even know why we're together, really.
Well, apart from the fact that we love each other.
Yes, Sean.
You're going to do the alloy as well? Sean! The best thing about Sean is his loving, affectionate... Don't grimace. Can we do that again, please? Don't grimace.
Let's just leave them to it. For the honeycomb, Anthony adds glucose and honey to sugar before heating.
That's got to go up to 150.
Unfortunately, it only goes up to 140 on the gauge. I couldn't find one with 150.
Look, it's starting to burn.
But I don't know where your timer is on your phone.
In goes goes bicarbonate of soda.
Whisk, 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 whisk.
And the fizzing mix is poured out to cool.
That's looking really good, actually.
Yeah,
I won't taste it now. So you've got to.
It is 150 degrees.
Yeah, you've got to let it cool now, so it'll be cooling for the next sort of like 5 hours, and then it'll go brittle.
The second part of dessert is the burnt surprise, a creme brulee which they'll torch later.
Basically, I'm going to make the brownies because that's what Anthony's letting me do.
Good luck. Amanda starts by melting chocolate and butter.
You should have done the chocolate first and then put the butter in.
I thought you were letting her do this bit. Amanda adds sugar and vanilla.
Make sure you get all them lumps out. Just do it right, will you?
Well, I'm holding a hot dish.
She's stressing me out. This is stressing.
What? Because you're making me nervous.
No, but you're stressing me out, aren't you?
And you're really helping. In go eggs.
Don't scramble it.
I won't scramble it.
And ground almonds. Oh, you couldn't resist, could you?
There.
Yeah, all right. Okay.
Finally, Anthony lets Amanda pour the mixture onto a tray for baking. Last to prep is the main, pan-fried duck breast with a vegetable fricassee.
I hope the duck breast is cooked properly and it's not, the skin's nice and crispy, but it's still pink. There's nothing worse than overdone duck breast.
I think Sean agrees.
I'm going to do this part of the course and you can stand there and look pretty.
Anthony whips up a garlic, soy and honey marinade, coats the breasts and will cook later. For Veggie LC, he's making a chestnut bourguignon.
We've eaten quite a lot of chestnuts as well.
Yeah, like
over the summer, there's a couple of trees in the local parks that we go around, we collected the chestnuts and that kind of thing, so not sure what relevance that's got to this conversation, but I like chestnuts as well.
Thanks for sharing. Anthony fries chestnuts, mushrooms and onions. Oh, we're quite the tosser, aren't we? On goes the pastry, ready to be cooked tonight.
Beautiful.
Prep done. Time to open some wine.
Oh, you're joking.
I knew it was going to do that. Oh. Oh, what to do now?
I'd put a new shirt on if I were you. Your guests are about to arrive. Oh, cheeky. First to the door, it's Sean and Steve.
Hi, I'm Sean.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Sean.
Hi, Amanda. I'm Steve. Hi, Steve.
Nice to meet you. Well, take you through here.
That's a very interesting portrait up there. It's
You'll see, there's quite a few. Anthony, you'll meet in a second. Okay. He's a bit of an artist.
Oh, really?
Most of the art around the house is
his. Fantastic.
Yeah.
That's great. It's
grab a drink.
Okay.
Great. Bloody Marys. I hope you like them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks,
second.
Amanda.
First couple are here.
Yes.
It's two boys.
Oh, excellent. That's
great. Yeah, Sean and Steve.
I'll never remember that, you know that.
Oh, yeah.
Hey.
How are you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. How are you doing?
And you?
Nice to see you.
Hi, Anthony.
I'm Anthony. Nice
to see you. I'm Steve. Nice to meet you.
I remember rightly, that's Sean and Steve.
No, Sean and Steve.
Such a bad memory. Sean and Steve. It's S and S, anyway.
At second to arrive are festival lovers Ollie and Elsie.
Hi, welcome.
Nice to meet you. Mwah, lovely to meet you. Mwah. Your name is Lou Elsie. Elsie, lovely. Hi, hi there. I'm Oliver. Hi Oliver. Nice Amanda. Nice to meet you. Coming through. Thank you very much. Cheers. Cheers, guys. And I'm glad our night's over tonight. <laughs> <laughs> Coming up, remarkable revelations. What do you both do for a living then?
Well, Amanda's a transvestite. Wow.
If you said that about me, I think that would be the end, wouldn't it?
And extraordinary reactions.
I'm not even joking. I can't even look at it.
It's the first night in Birmingham, where three couples are competing to throw the best dinner party. And tonight's host, Amanda and Anthony, are hoping to impress their rivals and win a grand.
Cheers.
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 Cheers, guys.
I have to say, I hadn't given any thought to there being a gay couple. But they seem really lovely.
Come on, are they gay couple?
Well, they might not, I suppose. Yeah, well, yeah. And the others are quite young, Elsie and Oliver.
God, you remember names well, don't you?
By the end of the night, I've probably forgotten.
While Anthony cracks on with the starter, Sean and Steve have a wander upstairs.
I'm very glam. Oh, OK, we have a boudoir. I'll have to get you doing one of these.
Absolutely not.
And a pair of French knickers.
No.
She's brave, and
she is.
Bet that floor was cold.
Well, the starter's all Amanda's got to worry about now.
I just hope that these duck eggs come out soft-boiled.
Anthony coats the eggs in breadcrumbs.
If the eggs don't go right,
oh, dear,
then he'll feel as though this course has been a disaster.
I will go to bed.
No, you can't go to bed. You've got to finish cooking.
No.
You can't leave me to it.
No.
The eggs are then deep fried while the asparagus cooks. And it's ready. Dippy duck eggs and soldiers.
Wow.
Thank you.
Not what I expected.
You're feeling all right, Ollie?
Guys, I've just got to tell you, I am almost phobic of eggs.
Excellent.
All right, OK. So I'm going to have to put the egg to one side. The asparagus and the...
No, that's fine.
Looks
delicious. No, that's fine.
But,
don't worry. No, it's
fine. The thing is, you're never going to please everybody.
No.
And the fact that he just turned around and said, I don't like eggs, it didn't offend me, didn't do anything for me.
Everything apart from the egg was fantastic, yeah.
Why you didn't eat your bread, though? Why did you not eat your bread?
Well, because the egg would have dripped onto it.
OK.
What's on the outside of the egg?
That's saffron breadcrumbs. It just gives a really nice coat on the side.
It really works. Mm. Lovely.
Thank you. I'm glad about that.
It was a boiled egg. It was nice, but it was a boiled egg.
It wasn't just a boiled egg, Sean. That was quite complex.
Know,
it was very complex as a starter.
From my taste, it was a boiled egg.
OK, but I'm just... From a technical point of view, it wasn't a boiled egg. It was a very accomplished dish.
Have you got that, Sean?
What do you both do for a living, then?
Guess.
No, cos I don't want to offend.
Well, Amanda's a transvestite.
Well.
And you were worried about offending.
I'm not, promise. She's looking at me as if you could be.
Nothing seems like a transvestite.
No, I'm looking at her.
No,
we're
not.
Mine, sympathy.
Are you?
We're very open-minded.
Is he telling me you're not telling me?
If you said that about me, I think that would be the end, wouldn't it? But she just goes, oh, hilarious, darling.
You'll get used to him, it's OK.
And that's what makes it OK.
There's us thinking, well, is she? Are we going to have to do the coffin drop? But no.
Well, you never know.
Transvestite, you know, that's what he put in my head. But she's not.
We met in a club called Baker's, and I turned round and she turned round and she had a zipped up Dolce and Cabana dress, which was up to here with that there, and I just went... She turned round and went... And that's it, we've been together ever since.
Oh,
18 years.
18 years.
So it was love at first sight.
Yeah. Oh, on to the main. Duck breasts are sealed and then cooked in the oven.
What do you want
now? Oh, no.
Big colander.
Yes, you keep putting stuff away.
No, I'm not putting, I'm just trying to do what you want me to do and clear up around you.
Wash.
Please. For the fricassee, Anthony fries up onions and mushrooms. Oh, dear.
Right, when that's cooked gently for a minute,
Coming out.
Can't blame Amanda for that. Good. In go chicken stock, bacon, lettuce and peas.
That looks fab, Ant. Well done.
Here it is, pan-fried duck breast with a vegetable fricassee. And for vegetarian LC, chestnut bourguignon.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Oh, wow.
Wonderful,
yeah.
Thank you.
You've got a phobia against ducks, have you?
No, no, I'm good. I'm not going with ducks.
No, you don't like something.
What's
their
patch?
This is pan-fried duck breast. Marinated with a fricassee and a mash.
That's delicious.
When we were upstairs.
Right.
Your photo shoot.
Okay.
Amazing. Was it a private one that you did yourself? Because
no,
some of them...
I wouldn't be able to show you the private ones. It definitely wouldn't be in a book.
Part of it was because I really wanted to do it because I've recently lost quite a lot of weight. Because... Well, when we came back off holiday in August...
No, that's not me saying. No, 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 that's
did
not...
Did you not say that?
Yep, he said it.
In my head.
No,
I didn't
No, that's not me saying it. That's what she said to me. She felt fat.
I thought that was really offensive. I would never say that to you. I can't really see an opportunity when that would be appropriate to say to anybody's partner.
Would you ever do something like...
I don't know.
I've got a camera.
Steady on.
Thank you, Anthony.
Quick, Ollie, change the subject.
Every summer, we both run a couple of businesses at the music festivals, but, you know...
Let him speak.
The original plan when we finished the festivals was I was going to move down to London. And I was going to rent my house out and we were going to rent a flat out in Islington or somewhere.
You've got a flat in Islington?
Shut up!
Ooh, Birmingham.
You're monopolising the conversation, will you shut up?
I haven't spoken hardly.
I don't think that Anthony has given Elsie and Ollie sufficient time tonight to talk about themselves.
No, I agree with that.
But if that happens in our night, then we will definitely put him in his place.
He's going to be shut down.
Yeah.
They'll start talking about something and Anthony wouldn't interrupt and cut them off before they've even had 2 seconds to talk about.
That's because they're boring the hell out of me.
No,
and I've got
but
to
you're
put something...
not letting them expand on what they're saying. And so before you know it, you've lost track of that conversation, you're onto something else, and they didn't
so
get a chance
to
talk.
So are you more interested in them then?
I'd like to get to know a bit about them. I know about you already.
Let's see how Anthony does this time.
So, Steve, what do you do?
I work in financial services.
Ah.
That was a conversation stopper.
Thoughts on the food?
It was a very good piece of duck. However, the skin wasn't crispy and it was lacking a sauce.
Yes, definitely.
It was a little dry.
My chestnut bourguignon was very good. It was a little bit dry, but I've never had chestnut bourguignon before.
I was really not happy with the main
course. You weren't happy with it, but I think it went down really well.
Maybe dessert will meet Anthony's high standards. He sprinkles his creme brulees with sugar.
Do you need to put the brownies on the pie and
I will
the place with the confetti?
The sugar's torched, the honeycomb cracked, and it's ready. Burnt English cream surprise.
Yeah. Wow. Thank you. Thank you. So, get a bit of the chocolate as well and the strawberry. But the most important thing is you must have a bit of this on top because that's the bitterness in the whole.
So, have you got enough room in your mouth after all of that?
I don't think Anthony will have a problem.
You are not seeing him outside of this house ever.
That was brilliant!
Right, can you all go now?
You do realise they're about to score you out of 20. Taxes!
Dessert was very nice.
I liked the dessert. Not I thought it was good. The creme brulee wasn't set.
It wasn't
however,
a creme brulee.
I enjoyed the textures.
I'm not really a big fan of honeycomb, but actually it was really delicious.
The dessert was amazing. I've just said.
Was it?
I have absolutely. Oh my god! I wolfed it down.
Was it that good?
I thought the food was fantastic. I thought Anthony was a little bit too overpowering.
I thought Anthony and Amanda just weren't quite attentive enough.
And for that reason, we're going to give them 14.
Anthony was a little bit gobby for my liking.
But Amanda's lovely.
But right. Well, overall.
So our score will be 13.
13.
That gives Amanda and Anthony 27 out of a possible 40, with two more nights to go. It's day two in Birmingham, and the turn of festival lovers Elsie and Ollie, who are hoping for a less dominant Anthony tonight.
Anthony, I found a bit overly confident at times.
He was a little bit loud and forward on some issues. So I think hopefully tonight he can just relax. We aim to make him feel relaxed anyway, and hopefully everybody get on and have a good time.
Last night was more about the Anthony show. Tonight we're going to rein him in a little so yeah. that Elsie and Ollie can enjoy their night.
I think Anthony should make sure that everyone gets their turn.
I won't say that.
You did have a lot to say.
Let's see what he's got to say about dessert. Poached pears with chilli chocolate ice cream.
And I'm not a sweet person, to be truthful. I don't eat an awful lot.
We're not really big into dessert, but
I'll have a bit of that.
Really, really like the dessert. Nice. That's my favourite dessert so far.
Chilli chocolate ice cream, winner.
Ollie is head chef for dessert, and his first task is to tackle his arch enemy, eggs.
Are you ready?
Are you kidding me?
Babe, this is you're doing dessert, so you have to do it. You've got to face your fear.
Right, let's do this. I'm not even joking. I can't. You'll have to do that.
Looks like the eggs won that battle then.
I can't even look at it.
While Elsie takes over, Ollie moves on to the less threatening chili.
You have to be really careful when you're handling these type of chilies because if you get the juice on your fingers and rub your face or you go to the toilet, you can get some serious consequences.
Can't be as bad as eggs. In go milk and dark chocolate.
It smells good. It does smell pretty good, doesn't it?
The mix is poured into an ice cream maker as the pears poach in spiced wine.
Well done, that's great.
Next, it's LC's turn with a vegetarian main, African sweet potato satay stew.
That sounds nice.
Really like the sound of that.
Very nice. I'm intrigued. The African sweet potato, though, what's that going to be? African?
Probably.
Is a stew a main course? Is that just... Have I read stew there? A satay stew? Right, we're going to have to get a chip shot before we go.
I defy someone to not like this. It's really, really good.
You'll have your work cut out with Anthony. LC starts by blending ginger and garlic. In it goes with sweet potato, curry paste, vegetable stock and water.
It doesn't look too appealing just yet. We just have to give it some time.
Keep the faith.
Finally, LC adds peanut butter. They'll serve with chickpeas and a herb salad. LC and Ollie will be hosting drinks in a specially erected festival tent tonight.
I think they all seem fairly up for a bit of a laugh. I think we should be able to pull it off.
Even if they don't like it, they won't let on, because they'll be wanting to be as cool as we are.
Yeah, cool, man. Last of prep is the starter, a festival of vegetables.
See, festival.
So that theme is coming in.
Yes.
A festival.
I reckon that's going to be quite flamboyant.
It's going to have vegetables in, we know that.
Yeah,
much.
We know that.
It's difficult to really gauge what that's going to be, maybe other than just vegetables.
Maybe we're going to have dancing vegetables, though.
A lot of it's about kind of educating people and just showing them the sorts of stuff that you can do with vegetables and not having to eat meat. I'm not 100% vegetarian, but I love a lot of the dishes that LC makes.
LC starts by making a coriander marinade, which she adds to roasted aubergines before drizzling with tahini.
I feel like I'm just in the background doing the washing up.
That's because you are. It's to be accompanied by a tofu and sesame salad. Prep done, it's time to get ready. First to the tent are Amanda and her outspoken hubby, Anthony.
Hi, guys. Welcome to our festival night. Do you want to come in?
Woo!
You? Oh, lovely, thank you.
Hello.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Yeah, great, great to see you.
Cheers to another good night.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to the chicken. Oh. You might be waiting a long time for that.
And next to pitch up, it's Sean and Steve.
Hello. Hi. Guys, come in. How are you doing? Welcome to our... Welcome to our festival evening.
Hello. Great to see you.
I knew something was going to be up in the way of a tent, so I'm not surprised by the festival theme at all.
I thought they put a lot of attention to detail into tonight's theme.
It portrays them very well.
Well, I guess it does, partners.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Coming up, astonishing admissions.
To be totally truthful, we just don't enjoy eating out.
I do think that's a bit odd.
And clashing couples.
No, hang on a second now. Anthony.
Where did that come from all of a sudden? You know, is that something deep down inside that you felt you needed to say to get a reaction?
It's night two in Birmingham, where happy campers Ollie and LC are cooking for two rival couples in the hope of winning a grand.
Cheers.
While the hosts prep their veggie starter, Anthony and Amanda have a nosy upstairs.
They've got rats! Oh, I love rats! Oh, yes, oh, yes.
Oh, they're lovely. What's that? The Birmingham chili eating contest. Oh, no, I saw that on the TV!
But I told you we should have bought him a chili plant.
Yeah, that's Ollie, isn't it? With pre-beard.
That's Ollie?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it is.
Is it?
Oh!
Has he been sick?
That's gross.
And if they've still got an appetite, the starter's nearly ready. LC tosses vegetables while Ollie bashes nuts.
I think you're beating me up.
Shut up.
And here it is, a festival of veg.
Amanda, thank you very much. Ooh.
Mange too.
The only thing I cannot eat in this world is aubergine.
Really?
I have a real phobia about it.
Oh, no, really?
However, it doesn't bother me that it's there.
Okay, you're gonna be
It's just that I'm not gonna eat it.
I really, really dislike aubergine as well.
Right.
But I'm willing to give it a go.
Popular choice?
I must admit, that is just so good. And I was willing not to like it. See, I wouldn't miss meat if it tasted like this.
Praise indeed.
The starter for me was a complete revelation. It was absolutely gorgeous, and fair play. Loved it. Every single bit.
The The starter was absolutely amazing.
It was gorgeous. It wasn't what I expected at all.
Back at the table, talk turns to Birmingham's curry district.
When you go and have a curry at the Balti Triangle...
Never would I have a Balti at the Balti Triangle.
Would you not? Why?
Because it's not very good, to be truthful.
I disagree with you completely.
Well, you obviously haven't...
You haven't had one of ours.
Oh, well, here's a challenge, then.
Yeah, but how do you know it's not any good if you haven't been there?
To be totally truthful, we just don't enjoy eating out. We've literally struggled to find a good restaurant in the last 10 years. Just never happy with the food.
In so 10 years?
Do you go out every so often just to check that it hasn't got any better?
That just sounds ridiculous, like not having a good
meal.
We
look forward to going out. We have to stop ourselves from going out because it's not just like the standard of, it's just like not having to cook it yourself. So I do think that that's a bit odd.
We're quite open though, and I think they're quite shut off to their standards of living, and I think that's where they stay. And if it's below that, they say, no, we're not going there.
Well, is that because of Amanda or Anthony though, do you think?
Anthony.
So, we had a little trip around the house earlier and we found a couple of visitors in your bedroom.
Oh, what an Oscar.
And they're so cute.
They have been long-standing members of the family.
Oh, and then, wow. Lo and behold, we see a picture of you, being sick.
Yeah, there was a picture. That was the after effects.
That was not nice to see.
No. So, yeah, it was the Birmingham Chili Eating Contest. First year I entered it, I came third.
Wow!
Out of about 12 people, I think it was.
Well, not so well.
And then the next year that I entered, I came 11th. There was an OAP in there, a couple of girls, and I thought I'd better hang my coat up. So, I don't enter them anymore. Really well.
Yeah, no, it really did.
I was quite surprised, actually. I thought Anthony was going to be our biggest critic. And he was actually massively positive about it.
Waxed lyrical, yeah, it was really good.
Couldn't shut him up about how amazing it was.
So if we can keep this up with the main, then I'll be really happy tonight.
Let's get it on the table, then. Vegetarian dish number 2, African sweet potato satay stew.
Bon appetit. I have to say, even just the look looks amazing.
Anthony, what do you think?
It is a bit washy for me, to be truthful. I would not expect a stew to be served to me as a dinner party, but we don't go to dinner parties, so whatever we are served is happily received.
It tasted beautiful, but there was no main piece of it.
There was so much chickpea. All I kept getting was chickpea. So it was kind of like
it was like having a film without a star.
Yeah.
The main course was fantastic. I'm not converted to vegetarian, but I'm willing to try that a lot more now.
You could take that into your dietary requirements, couldn't you? And mix it in. It was really, really good.
Personally, I think that was one of the best African stews that LC has ever made.
Thank you.
So all good. Me and LC were a bit concerned today, spending sort of 12 hours in the kitchen together, because we've both got habits that sort of annoy each other a bit. But actually, we got on quite well. But I just wondered if you guys have got any kind of habits.
Amanda farts.
He's back.
But I don't think I really do, in the way that it causes a problem.
My husband cannot close a flipping drawer if his life depended on it.
Oh, wow.
And especially... especially the dishwasher.
Oh,
he leaves it on a ledge.
I told you there was problems coming out.
You're hardly going to trip on it.
It's not about that. It's about the smell. Close a drawer after you.
He has skid marks in his pants.
What?
Skid marks. That annoys me.
Oh, someone's not happy.
There are serious cracks appealing in your relationship. I'm not, no.
Really?
No.
I said to Amanda.
They really aren't.
No.
Really?
You don't think so?
No, they really aren't.
And Anthony, I do think that might be a
No, there are things.
Also very wrong.
Okay, so there
hold
are
on,
things.
Hold on, hold
no,
on.
Hang on a second now.
Because
you said
some basic.
No, Anthony, what you've just said tonight is, I find, quite offensive.
Yeah.
Where did that come from all of a sudden? You know, with. Is that something deep down inside that you felt you needed to say to get a reaction? No one agrees with it at all, do they?
I find it really hurtful because I really like Anthony and Amanda.
I feel that you deeply offended you guys. And
but
I
would not
very
offend you.
Sad and upset.
In a way that Amanda thinks that I've offended you.
Do you think I'm right about their relationship?
No, actually, no, I don't. In this case, no, I don't.
Well, fair enough. That's good.
Really rude. Really unjustified and, well, I don't know. I didn't even know what to say.
Oh, shall we have some dessert? Poached pears with chilli chocolate ice cream. Has anyone got anything to say? Oh, home time.
I'm very disappointed with Anthony tonight. I've let him into my inner circle and he's disappointed me.
Yeah, he's let us down a little bit because we thought we knew him and it's just shown a different side to him completely tonight. It was very unexpected. Yeah, it was very nice, worked very well together. The chocolate ice cream I thought was a nice touch with the chilli and the warmth from the chilli I thought come through very well.
Hope it's not a long journey home.
The food seems to have been quite successful, but the kind of social aspect has been a bit tricky, trying to manage that. And we kind of, I think, took a bit of a back foot and let it run its course. But we hope that that doesn't really impact too much on the scores that we get from the other guests.
Well, it's time to find out.
So Alcine and Ollie tonight, perfect hosts, executed the menu very well, very impressed. From my point, I'm going to give an 8.
And from my point of view, an 8 as well. Really good vegetarian menu, so we're going to score...
16.
Unfortunately, we had a little bit of a disagreement, so I think overall, we're going to score them 14.
Despite the friction, Elsie and Ollie's vegetarian menu gets 30 out of 40, putting them in first place. It's the third and final day in Birmingham, and the turn of Sean and Steve to host, who are keen to put last night behind them.
I don't hold grudges. Once I've said my piece, it's done, it's out there, you know, you move on. There's no point in dwelling over things. So when Anthony arrives tonight, we'll welcome him into our house.
Yeah.
And, you know, we'll just take it as a new day.
Yeah.
A new chapter.
I hope for the sake of Sean and Steve that tonight is a good night. And also for our sake, because last night was really awkward for us.
And after a good night's sleep, Amanda and Anthony are also keen to move on.
I was more than a little bit upset by what happened last night with Anthony.
You're always upset anyway.
and I still feel that your behaviour wasn't really great. And I think we are going to have to just agree to disagree on our feelings over that.
Probably for the best. Back in the kitchen, Sean and Steve are about to get cracking.
I'm going to be Sean's sous chef for the dessert. The rest of the courses I will be cooking.
Because otherwise it wouldn't be edible.
First to prep is dessert, mango creme brulee with homemade shortbread.
I don't get excited. You know, like some people, we really get excited about creme brulee. But shortbread, I do get excited about.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to the shortbread.
Never had a creme brulee with mango. And I'm not really sure...
if mango and creme brulee...
whether it's going to go. But we shall see.
There won't be any mango if Sean can't open the tin.
This is the most ridiculous can opener in the world. It, for some reason, it just doesn't work for me at all. It's piercing it, but it's not taking the lid off. Oh, you do it. It's a conspiracy.
It's a simple job. Sean adds the mango to cream and eggs. In goes sugar, and it's given a whisk.
I don't like these.
Oh, careful!
Can you get me a cloth, please?
The mix is then poured into ramekins.
And just make sure when you that you clean around the edges so that it's...
I'm going to.
Otherwise it's going to burn.
Yeah.
Cleaned round the edges, it's covered and left to bake. Next up for Sean, the shortbread. He mixes butter with sugar and flour.
Come on, chip-chop
now. I am!
Before rolling out and chopping into biscuits.
Just make sure they're the same size.
Breathe. Evenly sized, the shortbread is given a bake.
Glad my part's over. And I'm just your sous now.
Yeah, this is where the hard work begins, though.
Oh, Sean. Next up, it's the starter, pan-fried scallops with chicken wings.
It's a very interesting combination, having fish and chicken. Some people, when you say it, they sort of give you a double take, but it really does work.
Be interesting to see how scallops go with chicken wings. I wouldn't necessarily have put the two together.
That's a strange one, to be truthful.
Mm.
Mixing the scallops with the chicken wings could be a little bit unusual. I presume they're not going to be sudden fried or something like that.
Slow cooked, actually, but first Steve breaks the wings.
This is brutal. Poor chicken.
Are you turning vegetarian now, Sean, after last night?
Hardly. Breaking bone and... Yeah, I don't want to hear that. I just want the food on the plate. It should just magically appear.
Well, it does usually. It's just you're involved today.
Well, that's told you. To a slow cooker, Steve adds duck fat, garlic and the chicken. He'll fry the scallops just before serving. Last to prep is the main, salt-crust venison and a stuffed mushroom for Veggie LC.
This is a pretty fantastic menu, isn't it? So this could potentially be, if they get it right, a threat to us winning.
You've got to cook that. And on a salt crust.
That timing's got to be good on a salt crust. Because it does keep it, keeps all the flavour in, but you can't see it, you see. You won't be able to see what flavour, what state the venison's at.
I really hope Anthony likes our main course tonight. You know, we're going to give him a nice big slab of meat and hopefully that will...
Fill his mouth.
Steve starts by searing the gobstopper.
When you carve it, it looks caramelised on the outside and then it will be very, very pink in the middle.
He then moves on to the crust, mixing salt with spices, egg whites, flour and water.
When Steve made this for me the first time, I never saw all the what goes into it. But seeing it now like this, I'm very impressed.
The venison will be cooked in the salt crust later. Prep done and the hosts are bracing themselves for tonight.
I'm worried potentially what Anthony's going to be like.
Put the past behind us. Yeah. And we're not going to dwell on it. It's a new night, it's a new chapter.
Try another laugh.
Better get changed then, your first guests are nearly here. It's Anthony and Amanda.
Hello! Oh, welcome! Hi. Come in,
nice
out the cold.
I know.
How are you?
Okay.
Mwah. Good,
how
you doing?
Yeah,
you good?
How
are you?
Good.
If you go through, Steve will meet you.
Hello. Yeah.
Good.
How are you, mate?
All
listen,
right.
Listen, I've got you a little present because of last night. And
okay.
I do apologise. And that's for you, some heaty rollers.
Thank you very much. I'll have great pleasure in curling my armpit
hair. Oh, God. I'm really pleased with the way Anthony came in, apologised. And I'm very proud of him. And like now, we can all move on. Everyone's at ease with each other.
Yeah.
We had a laugh straight away. That's it now, done, dusted.
To be honest, bit of a thick head this morning,
yeah.
I have to say.
I had a bit of a thick head after she stopped it to me. Thick hair.
And here's the couple to meet, Ollie and Elsie. I'm guessing that's a fake fur.
Good evening!
Hello. Love the hats. Oh, fantastic.
Hello. I'd like to say something, by the way, chaps. I hope I didn't spoil your evening last night, and I do apologise if there was any misbehaviour.
Not a problem. It's a new
evening,
night.
No,
Steve and Sean's like tonight, so let's make the most of it.
When we walked in, Anthony apologised immediately, and we were really pleased about that because it kind of drew a line underneath last night.
Meant we could start afresh.
To the final night.
Coming up, a wedding faux pas.
I drove home from my reception at 9 o'clock and went and watched X Factor and left her there.
There'd been an annulment in the post pretty swiftly.
And the winners are revealed.
Show me the money!
It's the third and final night in Birmingham and couples Sean and Steve are hoping to wow their opponents and win the £1,000 prize.
Cheers.
Cheers, guys.
It's the final night.
While their guests enjoy a cocktail, the hosts get on with the starter.
So then wipe the pan out, please. And that's the pan you're going to use for the tofu.
Can I put them out first?
I'm just explaining what you need to do, sweetheart. Just acknowledge.
Don't sweetheart
and
me.
Then we'll be fine.
Now, you two. The scallops and chicken wings are fried off, and it's ready. Pan-fried scallops with chicken wings. And a tofu version for LC.
Here we go.
So,
I hope you enjoy.
Ooh. I know it's quite a strange combination to put chicken with fish, but I actually quite like the chicken and the scallop with the celeriac puree. I think it does work for me.
When you bring something to the table that looks so good, it's got to taste so good. The scallops were overcooked. I was chewing my scallops where they should be sliced and they should melt in your mouth. There should never have been chicken on there.
No.
The starter looked fantastic, but the flavours were a bit too subtle.
Right.
And I don't think the fact that we had chicken and scallops there added anything to the dish.
How long have you been married?
5 years now.
5 years.
So these are pictures from the day, are they?
Yes, at the civil ceremony.
I drove home from my reception at 9 o'clock. And went and watched X Factor and left her there.
Pop Idol.
You did
it. Really? Was the final of Pop Idol.
Yeah.
And he just disappeared. I'm sure you're not. None of you can be shocked by that. I'm sure.
I don't know.
That's another level.
But they had to come and get me.
They had to come and bring him.
I was naked watching Pop Idol, and they were knocking on the door. And please come out. It's your wedding. I was like, no, I've had enough. I'm going to sleep.
We got married, and Ollie left our wedding reception to watch Pop Idol. I think. There'd been an annulment in the post pretty swiftly.
You will never cease to amaze me. You are absolutely unique. I just...
Oh, that's brilliant. That's brilliant.
I'm surprised you're still married.
Oh, brilliant. Yeah,
at the time, I was so angry.
No, I was. Why?
Why would I not be? It's not wedding reception.
Would you be hungry?
Oh, just make sure you hang around for the main. The venison's wrapped in a salt crust and then baked. Sean whips up a pea puree ready for Steve to plate up.
Do you want me to mop your brow?
Not really at the moment, Sean.
Maybe later, fella. And it's ready. Salt crust venison with a red wine jus and a stuffed mushroom for Elsie.
Oh, my goodness. Wow. Thank you. Wow.
I hope you like your meat pink.
Oh, my goodness. Wow.
It certainly looks pink.
Tuck in, everyone.
Thank you.
The main course with the dauphinoise was lovely.
They were delicious.
But the meat, which is your star, was still moving.
I mean, I love red, pink meat. That's how I want my meat, but that it kind of was looking at me raw.
It was raw. Yeah.
I think it was a little bit undercooked for a lot of people's taste buds.
They were very gracious in not bringing it up.
I'm a bit disappointed about that.
Perhaps a good story will go down better.
We were in a club in Birmingham. It was a gay club that had a phone party on a particular night. And I decided, I thought it'd be quite funny to lift Sean's T-shirt up with my teeth. However, I got hold of Sean's mole and bit Sean's mole off.
Oh, my goodness.
And he had to have surgery. It was very embarrassing at the start.
I think they're a great couple. They've been together quite a long time, quite established. They're awesome. They want to bite each other's moles off. Leave them to it.
And it seems Amanda loves Anthony, warts and all.
To you guys, you've only had a very small experience of Anthony. I've had 18 years, and so I know that in there is a really lovely person. And unfortunately, I kind of feel that some of that has been lost a little bit and that some of his character has maybe come across the wrong way. And I think that for us it's got to be a learning curve.
I think you're a lovely couple.
Thank you.
It's blatant to everybody how much you idolise each other.
Yeah.
And if we can be in the same place that you are in 18 years' time, then I would count myself a very, very happy
definitely.
Man.
Aww.
Definitely.
Oh, that's lovely.
Awesome.
Thank you.
And I mean that from the bottom of my heart.
They've obviously been together for a long time and they love each other very much. They're aware of the differences of opinion that each other have and I really respect them for that.
Most relationships don't last 2 years, never alone 18.
No.
But it doesn't matter, whatever knocks at the door, we can deal with.
Yeah.
Done and dusted.
Yeah.
Just one final course to go. Mango creme brulee with homemade shortbread.
I've done this myself, which I don't cook.
What, you've made this?
I've made it from scratch.
Oh, my God.
And the shortbread.
Pretty
the
good.
The shortbread tastes like I've just been to a really good Scottish...
Oh, thank you.
...biscuit factory.
I was really nervous about doing it.
Because that's really, really lovely.
The mango gave it a little bit of extra depth and it was delicious and I finished off Ollie's as well.
It would just really top what's been a wonderful experience off if we could win.
You're gonna need 31 or more to walk away with the cash.
I had a really good night tonight. The only thing I would say is that my start was maybe a little bit bland, but otherwise perfect, so I'm giving tonight an 8.
My venison was a little bit raw, so tonight I'm going to give it a 7. Together, we're going for
15.
So tonight, we're going to score Steve and Sean.
Hold your horses! All the scoring's been done in secret, so it's down to the host to reveal the results.
Wow.
Right, you ready? Third place. Amanda and Anthony.
Oh!
So it's between Elsie and Ollie, and me and you. Second place, Sean and Stephen. So the winner. Yay! Yay!
Anthony scored Sean and Steve 13.
After what happened last night, well done.
Well, thank you so much.
For us, yes, we would have loved to have won, but it's not for the money. It's about the winning that was the important part. The money was a bonus. We don't need the money.
Good job you didn't win.
Did that make sense?
Yes, it made perfect sense to me.
But that just shows a vegetarian menu can come through.
It's been a brilliant week. We've won £1,000. I don't think we could have done any better. Well done, darling.
Right, let's go.
I personally feel that I would like to keep in touch with Steve and Sean. I think personally, Anthony won't keep in touch with anybody, which is probably a good thing, really.
Probably. For more on Come Dine With Me, head to the Channel 4 website.
Helping a couple tackle more than just the one room, Kirsty's Fill Your House for Free is tonight at 8. Then at 9, how are new cost-cutting measures impacting on frontline staff? A chief executive finds out in a new series of Undercover Boss. Next, though, Homer wins on the horses in The Simpsons.